The impeachment trial of US President Donald Trump is coming to a close.
We've got the language you need to talk about this story. I'm Catherine.
And I'm Dan, and this is News Review. Let's hear more about that story from this BBC World Service News Bulletin.
Final arguments have been heard in the impeachment trial of President Trump. The Republican-dominated US Senate then adjourned. The chamber will now almost certainly vote to acquit the president in its concluding vote on Wednesday.
So, the impeachment process against President Donald Trump has nearly finished. Now, he's accused of abusing his position and then hiding the evidence. He is expected to be acquitted. That means found not guilty, because, in fact, the people making the decision are mostly from his party anyway.
Yeah, and they're going to back their man.
That's what's expected, yes.
Yeah. OK, well, we've got three words and expressions that you can use to talk about this story. What do we have for them, Catherine?
We have sputters, sham and constrain.
Sputters, sham and constrain. OK, let's have our first headline then, please.
Let's do it. So, first headline is from the United States, the New York Times. Democrats and White House rest cases as impeachment sputters towards a verdict.
Sputters continues weakly. Now, I'm going to say that again. Sputters. Sputter, putter, 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 putter. It's nice. It's got this rhythm to it. Sputter,
yes, putter, 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 putter. It's a nice word. Put, put. The put is quite what we call onomatopoeic. Uh-huh. Sputters is an onomatopoeic word.
That means it's a word that's spelled or pronounced like the sound that it represents, correct?
Exactly that. An onomatopoeia is when a word sounds like a sound.
Okay,
yes.
So like a cat would go meow,
meow,
and we would write M-A-I-O-W.
Yep.
Or we can have clap, C-L-A-P.
Sounds like the
exactly.
sound, yes.
Mm-hmm.
Click is another one,
yep.
Click.
Get one of those.
Spelled like it sounds. Sputters, spelled S-P-U-T-T-E-R-S, sounds like, it gives you the idea of this sound, which sounds like a car engine
yep.
when it's kind of trying to get going or is about to stop
yeah,
working.
You never want to hear your engine sputtering.
No.
You're driving along and you're thinking, oh, please don't stop whatever you do. I'm not there yet.
Yeah. And if you're about to run out of petrol and you hear that car going...
Yeah. What are the worst sounds?
And we're going to get there.
Yeah.
Please,
please.
Keep going.
Yeah.
Goes slower and slower, doesn't
mm-hmm.
it?
Yeah.
So back to our headline. The impeachment is sputters towards a verdict. It means it's almost there. It's quite laborious and difficult. And
doesn't have a lot of power, does it? It's kind of weak.
Not a lot of power, yeah. And it's the idea that it's going forward, this trial, but it's all a bit difficult and hard work.
So sputter is kind of it's a verb of movement and style, isn't it? You get this movement, but also you get the idea that you shouldn't be confident in it.
Or yeah,
it's kind of feeble and weak. It's not
weak,
powerful.
The adverb, it's a verb of kind of manner as well, you know, something sputtering, you know, it's not really making very smooth and steady progress. It's all a bit tired and exhausted.
Yeah.
You can talk of phrases with sputter include something can sputter to a halt or sputter to a stop.
So that would be like weakly continuing and then ending.
And then stopping, yes.
Like maybe a relationship between two people who don't really get on very
well.
Well,
it might sputter on for a while.
Uh-huh.
You can say something can sputter on and it means it keeps going very weakly and then finally it might sputter to a halt.
Yeah, and therefore end the relationship.
Yes.
Right, well, let's check out that information on a slide. Okay, let's go to our second headline then, please.
And we have another headline from the United States. The publication is Deadline. And the headline, Stephen Colbert stews over Senate's sham impeachment trial.
Sham, false, fake, or bogus. It's not a nice word to say, actually, sham.
Lovely word to say, isn't it? Sham.
Sham.
Spelled S-H-A-M. Sham. Now, this is all about fake, false, untrue things.
Mm-hmm.
It's a fairly specific use of it. If you think about fake, we often think about sort of fake handbags, fake watches, that kind of thing, where you pay like $10.
Yeah, I picked up a Zucci bag
the other day.
Not Gucci, Zucci.
It was a fake Gucci.
Yes.
Yeah, the Gucci was just...
Don't tell everybody.
I think it's quite obvious, actually. That the bits fall off all the time.
Yeah, it does.
So objects can be fake, but we don't normally say that objects are sham. The word sham we use for situations.
Oh, like the other day, when I got a phone call the other day, somebody phoned me up and said, guess what, Mr. Dan, you've won £1 million. And I was like, no way. And they were like, yeah, all we need to send you the money are your bank account details.
All right. Did you check out their website?
I did. It was very dodgy. They had misspellings all over the place and their icon wasn't quite right.
Yeah.
And I didn't trust it in the end.
So what with the dodgy phone call and the ridiculous promises and the bad looking website, you figured that this was all a sham operation.
Complete sham.
Okay. So something that's set up to look like the real thing, but it actually isn't. So you can have a sham business, sham operation, as we talked
sham
about.
Sham marriage.
Sham marriage, yes,
you get that
indeed.
A lot, don't you? You hear that expression a lot.
You hear, I was going to say.
Sorry, please don't misunderstand
too
me.
Too many people. But yes, if people get married for one day and then they go their separate ways, usually to get someone a visa.
Passport or something.
That's what we call a sham marriage.
Yeah.
Now, he's saying that the impeachment trial was sham. Now, that doesn't mean it was set up to be completely fake.
Yeah, or deceived.
What he's saying is that this trial, he's describing it as sham because it's lost credibility. This might mean that it's disorganized, that the people in the trial aren't trustworthy.
Maybe it's corrupt.
Can be that it was corrupt, one-sided. Mm. It's not believable. It's not trustworthy. It's not credible, in his opinion. It doesn't mean that it's actually set up to be false.
No.
But when procedures go wrong because of corruption, mismanagement, bad practice, the wrong people being there, the right people not being there, a criticism of this process can be that it's sham.
Yeah, it often happens in elections when the losing party, once they've found out that they've lost, suddenly goes, oh, it was all a sham. Like, they badly managed it. It was all
they
a terrible sham.
Yeah. And the winner's going, no, it was completely above board and fine.
Yeah.
And we can use it also to suggest maybe if you go for a job interview, you don't get the job, and then you think, and you might say, well, that was a sham. It wasn't a real job interview. It was real, but they didn't do it. They only did it because they had to, because they knew who they were going to give the job to all along.
Yeah.
So for me, it was a sham.
So we have the first meaning, which was something that's intended to deceive people. And then we have the second one, which is the badly managed situation.
Kind of badly managed, so you lose trust in it. Yeah.
Yes, but here's something you don't need to lose trust in. It's our slide. It's not a sham at all. Okay, now before we go to our third and final headline, this is not the first time that News Review has covered Donald Trump being in controversy, is it, Catherine?
No, and I'm sure it won't be the last, but we can look back to another previous News Review where we covered a story where Donald Trump was being accused of racism. Now, to see more of this story, just click the link and you'll go straight there.
Wonderful. Okay, let's have a look at our third and final headline then, please.
Okay, so this one's from Australia, the Sydney Morning Herald, and the headline is, "You cannot constrain him. Democrats condemn Trump as threat to democracy."
Constrain, control or limit. This is a verb, isn't it?
This is a verb, constrain, C-O-N-S-T-R-A-I-N, and the stress is on the second syllable, as Dan will demonstrate.
Constrain. Constrain.
Thank you very much, Tom.
Welcome.
Yes. It's related to limiting freedom. Mm. Now, this means we often use it in a kind of business sense or in a political sense when people are not allowed to do absolutely anything they want. There are limits of the things that you're allowed to do. Now, imagine, Dan, you've decided.
Yes.
You're not going to be a teacher anymore.
Done. Decided.
You're now going to be a builder, property developer.
Got it.
You've found a lovely piece of real estate, a beach, little cottages.
Oh, sounds
few
idyllic.
Few fishing boats.
Sea turtles?
Yes.
Excellent. Perfect place for my new casino. Yeah.
I don't think so.
20 stories high with neon lights.
Absolutely not.
No?
No.
Why not?
There will be constraints on what you're allowed to do. That means rules and regulations probably put in place by the local council that said you can't have buildings more than six floors high, you're not allowed alcohol, a gambling license. There will be rules and regulations to limit how much you can do. So yes, you can build something, but you can't build your 20-storey casino.
I will be constrained. That's
you
a passive
will
form.
Be constrained.
It's commonly used that way, isn't it?
Very commonly, yes. You can be constrained.
And I noticed that you used the noun was constraint.
Yes, the noun was constraint. That's well right. done, Dan. Well
Thank you very much.
Spotted.
I'm doing all right today, aren't I?
Okay. So, yes, we use it in the passive form. It's not just for buildings. We can have things like you can be constrained by many different things, like budgets. Mm. You can talk about budgetary constraints. Now, back to the headline. The Democrats aren't talking about, well, they may be talking about the rules and regulations, but this is really a comment on Donald Trump doing pretty much what he wants to do. They're saying it's very difficult to control him, whether by rules and regulations or by other means, but they're saying he's difficult to control, to keep within the limits of his presidential powers, if you like.
And due to the format of news review, we are constrained, so let's go to a slide. Now, could you recap the vocabulary for us, please, Catherine?
I could. We had sputters, continues weakly, sham, false, fake or bogus, constrain, control or limit.
Thank you very much. Now, if you'd like to test yourself, there's a quiz you can take on our website. Don't forget, we're also all over social media. And thank you very much for joining us on this news review. We hope to see you next time. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Thank you for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it. Remember, we have lots more videos for you to watch to help you improve your English. Remember to subscribe to our channel and good luck with your studies. Bye.